Hey YouTube, I'm back with another video. This one is gonna go through my horror movie collection. I have two piles here. One is new stuff and one's old movies. And I think I got most everything. There's a couple where I was kind of on the fence, where I was like, it's kind of a horror movie, but not really. And then some that are just fun Halloween type movies. God, I forgot to show my shirt off. Let's see, I'll just get into it. And they're not in any like particular order or anything. I think I'm gonna pick one from each pile. You know, go back and forth. So on this side of the new ones, I've got Zodiac. And that's a David Fincher movie, and it's pretty creepy. It's based on true events, and they never catch the killer. And it's got Mark Ruffalo, Jake Gyllenhaal, and Robert Downey Jr. It's a pretty good one. It's kind of long. That's all I'll say about that one. And then I watched this last night for Halloween. Night of the Living Dead, I've seen it a few times. It's classic. It's got great music and sounds that make you feel like you're back in 1968. And good actors going doing one of the first zombie movies ever made, and it's just kind of lays the groundwork for other horror movies. And then on this side, I got Pan's Labyrinth. It's a bit of a horror movie. More of a fantasy movie, I guess, but fun to watch on Halloween. It's Guillermo del Toro directed it. And it's about a little girl that goes to these kind of dark fantasy worlds and has to save herself and her little brother and her mom. And it's a pretty sad movie and dark. Evil Dead 2. This is a really funny, scary movie. It's kind of over the top, directed by Sam Raimi, starring Bruce Campbell, and part of the Evil Dead series with Army of Darkness. I don't have Evil Dead 1. I don't really like that one as much, but I do have Army Darkness, so I'll talk about that one later. Bruce Campbell does a great job kind of hamming it up and doing physical comedies. Okay, on the newer side, I've got The Host. Bong Joon-ho, this is one of my favorite movies. It's a monster, big monster movie. They dump chemicals in the river, and a monster comes out and abducts people and abducts this little girl from his family, and it's got Song Kang-ho. He's got a great smile. He's a great guy. I like him in movies. One of my favorite actors, because he's just a charming guy. He does good movies. The Terminator, Arnold Schwarzenegger, and James Cameron directed it. This is a good one for Halloween. It's got this, what do we call him? Robot guy. The Terminator chases after Linda Hamilton, Sarah Connor. And it's got some time travel elements in it, and it gets pretty scary at the end. I don't think I included Terminator 2. I have that movie, but it's not as scary, I guess. Then we got the Batman on the newer side of things. Takes place on Halloween and has the scary Riddler. Or is that who he was? It's been a while since I watched it. Maybe if it was called the Riddler, I would have known it was the Riddler in this one. Yeah, it was the Riddler. With Paul Dano as the Riddler and Batman is what's his name? Robert Pattinson. I really liked him as Batman and Bruce Wayne. And I like him as an actor and his movie choices. On the older side of things, we got The Thing, and this one is probably an all-time favorite. Pretty scary scenario in the Arctic. A dog comes along to this base where all these guys are in it, and MacReady is the main character. But they all kind of get a lot of, you know, you kind of get into all the characters pretty good in this one. And they, yeah, like Windows and other guys with names. Directed by John Carpenter. It's, and the creature effects are really good in this. Really creepy stuff. And the flamethrower, if you got a movie with a flamethrower in it, you know it's going to be good. Midsummer definitely lacks the flamethrower, but is pretty creepy and dark and scary in the beginning, especially. And it just gets kind of weird and things unfold. Danny, played by Florence Pugh, goes on a trip with her boyfriend and his friends to Swedish village, and they're celebrating midsummer, and it's scary. Alright, now another all-timer great, Alien. This one is perfect. I heard it was called Jaws, like Jaws in space, but I don't, it's scarier than Jaws. I don't consider Jaws too much of a horror movie, but it's like more of a summertime horror movie, like kind of like Midsummer. I wouldn't watch that for Halloween, but this one I would, and I frequently do. And it's directed by Ridley Scott, starring Sigourney Weaver, and the alien is excellent. And it's got a great cast with like Harry Dean Stanton and John Hurt. Yaphet Kotto, another great character actor guy in that one. I already drew from that pile. Moving on to 2018 Suspiria. I watched this last night for Halloween, or in the morning. It was really dark and rainy. I put it on, actually. It's got Tom York does the soundtrack. I probably won't say his name right. Luca Guadagnino. I don't know. Is the director. He did like a new one that looks interesting called The Bones and All or something like that. And this is a remake, but it's different than the original. The ending's a lot different, and this story is, they interweave a couple different stories that are different than the original. There's a great story with the doctor that comes in, and it's pretty moving, I thought, when that story wraps up. And then great ending. Dakota Johnson was really good as Susie Bannon, or Bannon, I don't remember. All right, Beetlejuice, classic comedy with Michael Keaton and Gina Davis and Alec Baldwin. And of course, Winona Ryder. And directed by Tim Burton. This one's really fun and good for Halloween. Good effects and stuff. And then this one maybe we'll get rid of Halloween 2018. It's not that great. But I did like the trilogy overall. This is a new Halloween movie, and the latest, the third installment, just came out a couple weeks ago. And they just wanted to stop Michael Myers from doing the killing. Hellraiser, Clive Barker's Hellraiser, another old one that's fun. It's just got creepy guys and a lot of inflicting of suffering and pain and gruesome ways. A Quiet Place one. This one's okay. It's a nice fall movie, I guess. And I liked it the first couple times I watched it, but then maybe after a while I'll like it again. John Krasinski stars and directs with Emily Blunt, and the kids were pretty good in it. The sequel I didn't really like too much, but the beginning of it was awesome, I thought. The Fly, David Cronenberg's The Fly, starring Jeff Goldblum. Very good creature. Transformation, mutating guy turns into a fly guy. With Gina Davis, too. And then we got Annihilation. This one is good and creepy. Not too much of a horror movie, but it gets pretty scary, I guess. It's got a scary alligator and a bear, and they're all mutated. It's actually kind of, I thought it was beautiful looking, with like, there's like flowers that are mutating, and it looks really cool, but there's a lot of creepy stuff in there too. The ending's really good. Then we got the sequel to Alien, Aliens. It's pretty good. This one's James Cameron. More of an action movie that people say, but it's still scary. A Ghost Story. More of a nice movie to watch. Good for Halloween. There's this ghost. Casey Affleck dies and becomes a ghost and wanders through his house, and Rooney Mara is his wife, and he kind of watches her, and then the house changes owners, and he kind of travels through time. It's pretty cool. Phenomena, Dario Argento's Phenomena. Really interesting. Jennifer Connelly at a young age, and she like controls bugs. And then the ending of this movie is so good. It gets pretty creepy, but then I don't want to spoil it, but there's a monkey and it's just fantastic. As Above, So Below. I feel like not many people watch this one. It's upside down. It's like a found footage kind of style where the camera is always running the whole time, and they go underground Paris to the catacombs, and it's really kind of like a hell place. I thought it was really well done for this kind of movie. It creeped me out and intrigued me. Then I got Nightmare on Elm Street 1 and 2. Classic Freddy Krueger invades the kids' nightmares, kills them in their sleep. It's got Johnny Depp in one of them. The first one. I don't remember the second one too well. Freddy's Revenge. Wes Craven. Good one. Good for Halloween. Then I've picked out, what's this one called? Under the Skin with Scarlett Johansson. And this one's really bizarre and gets freaky towards the end and kind of sad. Scarlett Johansson's like an alien that's infested, or like the alien picked this person to be, kind of. Underneath her skin is alien, and she just abducts men in her van and takes them to this weird goop place, a dark goop. And then there's like some really interesting scenes, and I don't know. And then the soundtrack is really good on this one. And then I got Ghostbusters 1 and 2. Haven't seen these in a while, but I'm sure they're still probably funny. Ivan Reitman and Dan Aykroyd, of course Bill Murray and Ernie Hudson, Annie Potts, what's his name? Rick Moranis too. Yeah, Rick Moranis, Harold Ramis, Dan Aykroyd, Sigourney Weaver, of course. And I'm sure y'all know what Ghostbusters is like. Paranorman. Just remember the symmetrical stacking quote from Ghostbusters. Anyway, Paranorman is Laika Studios animated film, stop motion animation. This one's pretty fun. About a boy who really likes Halloween and ghoulish things, and he talks to his dead grandma, and he has to like solve this, what's going wrong with these like witches and things in town. Looks great. And then I got Gremlins here, more of a Christmas movie for me. It takes place on Christmas. It's kind of a fun comedy. I love this movie. What's his name? Joe Dante did this one. Steven Spielberg presents. And Phoebe Cates is in it. She's great. Zach Gilligan is the main guy. And this is like a Mogwai. His name's Gizmo. And if you get water on him, he will multiply. And if you feed any of the Mogwais after midnight, they turn into gremlins. You can see the shadow of one here. Here's a good picture of one on the back wearing sunglasses. That's Stripe. Then I got Let the Right One In. Vampire movie. Is it Swedish or... I don't know. Danish. Those countries over there, they get me confused. Anyway, this one, vampire girl and her dad, maybe it's her dad, you don't really know, I don't think, move in next door, and this little boy gets bullied, and the vampire girl becomes friends with them and helps him out when he gets bullied. That's pretty good. They just came out with the TV show version of it, and I've been watching it. It's a lot different. It takes place in New York, and they've got a lot of different things going on in it. Now for E.T., the extraterrestrial. Not too scary, but it takes place on Halloween. Pretty fun. Classic movie, Steven Spielberg. Spielberg. And then Coraline. I realize this video is getting pretty long. I'll try to go a little faster. Another Leica Studio one. Girl finds a little doorway to another house where she thinks she has a better family on this other side, but they're actually really creepy and they want to keep her forever. Poltergeist. This one is an all-time favorite right here. Little girl gets sucked into a TV world. I don't know. Into another dimension. and the family is haunted and they want to try to save her. It's really good. Blade Trilogy. Blade 1, Blade 2, Blade Trinity. The first one's the best one, and by the third one, he doesn't even say any lines. It's kind of lame, but it's still good vampire hunting. And then I got Halloween 2 and 3. This one, Halloween 2, takes place directly after the first one. It's pretty good. Michael Myers doing killing. Halloween 3 is a complete departure in the series. It's about like some toy company that's brainwashing everybody to probably kill. I don't remember. And then Drag Me to Hell, Sam Raimi. This one I rewatched recently and it just blew me away. And I got it from the library and then I bought it. It's pretty fun, Sam Raimi style. He did Evil Dead and Spider-Man. And what's her name? Alison Lohman was really good in it, and Justin Long. And it was just a good ride for a movie. Not too scary, a little bit scary, and then like, there could have been more happening in it, but it still was a pretty good movie. I recommend it if you haven't seen that one. Then I got The Shining here. Stanley Kubrick's The Shining, based off of Stephen King's book, with Jack Nicholson and Shelley Duvall. This is where the guy goes crazy in the mansion. Tries to kill his family. Gear. This came out on the Criterion recently. I watched it for the first time like a week or two ago. It's pretty creepy, about hypnotizing people to do killing. And it's just one guy that has like a lighter and he like gets people to look at it and hypnotizes them. Then I've got Friday the 13th, Uncut, Friday the 13th, Part 2, Part, and then 3D, and then the final chapter. My favorite of all of them is Friday the 13th 3D. I actually saw it in 3D right before COVID, a couple years back, and with the red and blue glasses on at the theater. It was really fun. And then Donnie Darko, more of a sci-fi movie, but it takes place on Halloween. And it's a little bit creepy and mostly interesting. I really like that one. Werner Herzog's Nosferatu, the vampire. Starring Klaus Kinski as Nosferatu, the vampire. Maybe he has a different name. Count Dracula or Count Chocula, something. I feel like he had a name in this. Anyway, this one's great. The music in it, Popova, really. Great soundtrack. I'm getting confused on which side to pick from. Frighteners with Michael J. Fox, directed by the Lord of the Rings guy, Peter Jackson. And then it has Jake Busey as the scary guy in this movie. Jamie Foxx. This one's super good, and I feel like maybe not a lot of people watch it. Jamie Foxx is like he sees ghosts, and he goes around helping people with their poltergeists, but really he's just like sending ghosts into people's houses to throw plates around or whatever. And then he comes in and he gets money to get rid of them. But they're really his friends. But then the real scary ghost comes out. And he has to stop it. Getting on to Halloween 1. Classic John Carpenter with a good soundtrack. Jamie Lee Curtis. Slasher. Love this cover. People Under the Stairs is fairly new to me. I saw it for the first time a couple years ago. Maybe one or two years ago. And it's really good. Really creepy. It's got a... Oh, it's Wes Craven. And Everett McGill is in it from Twin Peaks. Big Ed. And he plays a creepy guy. So kind of a different role for him. And this one, yeah, there's people trapped in their basement and the little boys running around trying to escape. Then I forgot House. This is a Japanese movie. Usually says from 1977. It's more of a fun movie with kind of Scooby-Doo like effects. And it's really, I recommend that one if you haven't seen it. Silence of the Lambs, classic, with Anthony Hopkins. And Jonathan Demme is the director. And Jodie Foster, of course, as Clarice. Getting closer to the end. Suspiria, Dario Argento's Suspiria. I already talked about the first one, but I didn't really explain the plot. As a woman comes to this dance studio where she is kind of unraveling a mystery of what's going on there, and it's like actually run by witches. Stephen King's It, classic, two-part movie. This is the old one. The new one is mediocre. I like the one when they were kids a little bit better. And then the one where they're adults, and the new one was like super long, and I didn't really like it. This is pretty good with Tim Curry as the clown guy. It's pretty scary. It freaked me out when I was a kid. And another, more of a Christmas movie, Black Christmas. Spoiler, the killer is upstairs. calling from inside the house. Army of Darkness. Sam Raimi. Very good, really funny, and it was really a classic when I was a kid. A lot of these movies I ended up seeing when I was a kid because my dad really liked horror movies. He didn't watch this one, though. Texas Chainsaw Massacre, this one's really freaky. Definitely creepy. Tobe Hooper, who also did Poltergeist. And then I've got Creature from the Black Lagoon, old-timey. And then the Monster Collection, Dracula, Frankenstein, Wolfman, Invisible Man, Bride of Frankenstein, and The Mummy. All these classics. Alright, that's all. Almost 30 minutes of video. Enjoy.